You cannot force people to treat you with respect and as a professional. If you want to be treated with respect and you want to be treated as a professional, then you must act like a professional.
Hello, I am the Oklahoma Tomcat and I am here at the Road Angel Trucker Center, where you can get free food, free laundry, free shower, and plenty of truck parking. The sad part is, you will not find this place just driving by on the interstate, nor will you find us on many GPSs. So, how do truck drivers find out about this place? Well, there's an app for that. Trucker Path is a trucker GPS, and more than just truckers can use it, that is easy to use, and it has a whole lot more information than most of your GPS units. Not only will it tell you the best route to take, and the time to take there, and all that stuff, but it also gives you way station information, updated by fellow truckers, and it also gives you more than just truck stops, but it also gives you other parking places where truck drivers can park. It also gives you a lot more information on those locations, giving you the what the parking status is, and also reviews by other truck drivers. This way, so you can tell whether it's a place you want to park at, what services they have, and all the other stuff, and you will know whether how much parking there is before you even get there. As Trucker Path, you'll find the link in the description of this video. Click on it. Download it. You can download it for free, and many services are free on there. Check it out. That's Trucker Path.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How's everyone doing? I am the Oklahoma Tomcat, and I wanted to do a second part of a previous video I did, which was entitled Convoy to DC. If you haven't seen that video yet, I recommend that you go ahead and pause this one, go back and watch that one first. That way, so you get the whole message and see why I do not support a convoy and protest here in the United States by truck drivers. But in that video, I did make a couple of mistakes. Actually, one mistake. Only one. And that is the date of the protest. Apparently, the federal government was suspecting a protest, a different type of protest by different people in March, and that kind of got things confused, and the wrong information was put out saying the protest was after the Super Bowl. But it turns out that the protest is actually going to happen in March by truck drivers. One of the things I mentioned is that no one's been able to tell me yet what the American protest was. We know what the Canadian protest was about and is about. And that is the mask mandates. And in the previous video, I explained about that and about their government versus our government. But somebody came through for me in a post on MeWe. Somebody did tell me what that protest is about. Supposedly. I mean, this comes from the person. So, I mean, and he said, well, if I'm not mistaken, it's a multi-motivated. I'm sorry, I'm trying to read his post, but having a little bit of difficulty here with the sentencing. The convoy and blockades in Canada that represented truckers against a ridiculous mandate of the masking and vaccinations, plus truckers here in America are getting tired and being treated like S. They are hoping a good week or two shutdown will cause the stores to close shop and people start appreciating what truckers do for the economy and their way of living. Okay. Okay, and that's okay, and that's the only one that's actually come through and told me what this mandate is actually about. And on that note, I still do not support it. I mean, the mandate, what the trucker convoy and protest is about, and I still don't support it. Okay. And here is my issue with that. Okay. And basically, it boils down to respect, and that truck drivers feel like they're not getting the respect they deserve. One of the huge problems is we are not humble. Okay. Because what do truck drivers do for the economy and for the country and things like that? I'm going to tell you something. A lot of careers out there is needed. And a lot of careers out there do help out the economy, are important to the economy, and are important for our health, which I think is more important, and important for our comfort. Okay. But what distinguishes the difference between one career getting lots of respect and being recognized and versus another one? And really, that has to boil down to the people in that career. Let me ask you something. Doctors are important, right? Very, very important. They get a lot of respect. And for obvious reasons, I mean, you'd say, yes, they are important. I mean, we do need doctors, and they do a lot for us. But let me ask you something. If a lot of doctors started showing up to work and working while wearing flip-flops and dressed real bad, I mean, some of them even looking like they're on vacation at the beach, and peeing out in the parking lot, throwing trash everywheres, throwing their pee bottles out, you know, for everyone to see. Do you think they would still get respect? Would you go to a doctor that did that? And I hope the answer is no. But doctors carry themselves pretty good. I mean, especially at work, right? I mean, they dress professional and they look good and all that stuff. They take good care of themselves. How about if the majority of the doctors were hot-headed? Would they get a lot of respect? I mean, if they were yelling at everybody, getting real short-tempered? No. I mean, and I doubt very much you would go to a doctor that did that. I mean, who wants to hear a doctor yelling all the time and, you know, treating people with disrespect? And that's another thing. If you disrespect other people, why do you think you're going to get respect? You know? Truck drivers, we are our own worst enemy. We really are. And me personally, I try to point this out to other truck drivers, you know, is, you know, the way you carry yourself is the way you're going to, the way the trucking industry is going to look, you know, to society. If you're going down the highway, honking your horn all the time, yelling, getting, throwing, you know, a fit and stuff like that, and if you're going into, truck stops and giving the cashier a hard time, throwing fits and yelling at them and all that, for some they came in control. I mean, they're just an employee. Peeing in the parking lot where other people can actually see you. Come on, I mean, you're not even trying to hide. I mean, and not to mention peeing in the parking lot on concrete where it's gonna stink and everything. And throwing your pee bottles out. You know, not even throwing them in the trash or something like that. You know, no, I mean, people are not going to have much respect for you or look at you as, you know, important. Like I said, there's a lot of careers out there that's important. I mean, us truck drivers during the pandemic, early in the pandemic, when everything was getting shut down, we saw how important restaurants are, that minimum wage, under minimum wage waitresses or waiter, the cashier and all them. We found out how important they were when you were unable to get something to eat. So, are they important? Yes, of course they are. You know, garbage men. Yeah, they're very important. Okay. I mean, if you doubt me, ask New York City back when all the garbage men went on strike. Transportation in general, I mean, bus drivers, the city buses, the subways, all of them, very important people, okay? We can't do our job if we don't have customers ourselves, right? So, you know, that customer on that forklift, I mean, that person on that forklift that you give a hard time, very important. Why aren't you treating them with respect? I mean, the list goes on. And if you want to really look at important, okay, is every truck driver really important? You know, if every truck driver got shut down, yes, you know, there would be a issue with the importance of freight not getting hauled. But there are some truck drivers, there are times truck drivers aren't hauling important freight, you know. So, I mean, is that really important? I would say that garbage man is more important in his job than you are in yours if you're hauling, you know, Game Boys or whatever, you know, because that there is just, that freight is just, you know, yeah, it's nice, but not important. So, you know, if you want to get treated with respect, if you want to be seen as a professional, you have to look like a professional. You have to act like a professional. You have to carry yourself like a professional. And drivers, stop making excuses for bad behavior. There's been times I would, you know, criticize an action of a truck driver, and man, I get pounced on because of that. And I'm sorry, if I see bad behavior, I'm going to point it out, you know, and you guys defending that bad behavior is not helping us at all. And you cannot force people to see how important you are or to treat you like a professional. You can't force people to treat you like a professional. You can't. And protesting and shutting down to hurt people and say, hey, you're going to see me as a professional, or I'm not going to deliver this freight. That's not the way to go about it. And that's not to go about getting, you know, people to like you. In fact, probably going to make backfire on you, you know. Because keep something in mind. When you do something to hurt other people, and they can come back and hurt you twice as much. And how can they do that? Well, go to the government. and tell the government, hey, get these truck drivers back to work, or, you know, punish them. So rather than shutting down, I would recommend, let's start setting an example. Dress better. I mean, you don't have to wear a uniform like I do, you know. I mean, even back in the days, my dad, he was a truck driver. He dressed decent, you know. I mean, he didn't dress like a doctor or anything like that, but he wore a good shirt, you know, flannel shirt or whatever, and, you know, jeans and boots, you know. He dressed for the job. He looked like a professional. It was like mechanics, you know. I mean, when you need work done on your car, take it to a mechanic. And, you know, of course, a mechanic is a worker, so he's not going to, you know, have a suit on and all that. But, you know, he's going to dress professionally. You know, he's going to look the part. You know, some of them have uniforms. Dress better. At least do that. Stop peeing in the parking lot. Stop throwing your pee bottles out, you know, for other people to pick up. And with that, you know, I talked earlier about how store employees are important. These stores are important, you know. Number one, without the store, you're not delivering freight. So that does make it important. We need stores to do our job. And of course, we need stores to be shopping and stuff like that. Those employees are important. If every store employee went on strike, you'd be hurting, wouldn't you? Then why is it that truck drivers, who are supposed to be professionals and wants to be treated like a professional, throwing their pee bottle and trash on the ground for a store employee who is not making very much money to pick up? Why are you treating that store employee like a professional? Why are you treating them like trash? And you want respect? Rather than forcing people to treat us with respect and as a professional, start acting like a professional, start dressing like a professional, and start being a professional. That's how you get society to start looking at you in a better light. This is Oklahoma Tomcat. Y'all take care. God bless you.